एग्जैक्टली द कंप्यूटर इज. कंप्यूटर एज वी नो इज डेराइव्ड फ्रॉम द वर्ड कंप्यूट विच मीन्स टू कैलकुलेट. दैट मीन्स कंप्यूटर इज नॉर्मली कंसिडर्ड एज अ डिवाइस विच हेल्प्स इन बेसिक अर्थमेटिक एंड लॉजिकल ऑपरेशंस. इफ वी टॉक अबाउट द बिगिनिंग ऑफ सिविलाइजेशन, इनिशियली वी यूज फिंगर्स एंड पेबल्स फॉर द पर्पज ऑफ कैलकुलेशन. इनफैक्ट द वर्ड डिजिटस इन लैटिन मीन्स फिंगर्स एंड कैलकुलस मीन्स pebbles. By these two words we may be having a clear clue about the origin of computing devices. Initially it was used for the purpose of calculation, but you people will be surprised to know that presently only 20% computation task is being done. For the rest, you people may be knowing that we use computer for other applications like data processing, for entertainment, for game playing, etc. So what exactly computer is? We can say that an electronic device that stores the data based upon the instructions provided by user, it processes it and produces the desired result. So, in this definition, you people will be seeing the basic operations done by a computer is storage provided by the user, that means input you provide, and process and produces the desired result or output. So, with the help of diagram, we can explain it in this manner that we provide some input, that means the data, or I call it raw facts and figures. Based on these inputs, what user is demanding, we process the result and it is to be handed over to any output device, which can be, you may call it when it is data, you may call it is your desired result, or it is your information. It is your desired result. So according to this definition, if I ask what are the operations performed by a computer, then your answer should be, first operation is storage operation related for storing the data, or better if I put input operations at first, input operations, then processing operations, and last is output operations. By input operation, I mean that obviously we people generally talk in terms of high level language, and computer can understand the data in the form of 0 and 1. So to convert our input in the computer understandable form, it must be converted. So all the operations related to the conversion of input to computer understandable forms comes under input operations. Then what I mean by processing operations, in processing operations all those operations which acts upon the data so that it can generate user's output are comes under processing operations. Say for example, user may be interested that there are two data in the form of A and B, and the operations which we want to perform is plus. So our computer will generate certain signals and tell these instructions to computer so that addition of these two number can be done. And after processing the data, all the informations, all the desired output is handed over to any output device, whether it is monitor or it may be printer. But if the same data is supposed to be stored for future reference, then all the operations related to how the informations are stored in different media comes under storage operations. In output operation, as we have just discussed, that in input information from high to low are converted. Reverse of this is done in output operations. Matlab, from machine understandable form to user understandable form, data is supposed to be converted. So this is little idea about how computer works and what exactly computer is or how it works. By this definition or by seeing this diagram, we are having clear cut image that computer, it is better to call a computer information processing device rather than computing device. Computer is in present form. Can we group these computers in certain categories or how they can be classified? So now we are discussing how, what is the classification of computer. Obviously, it is the angle from which we are observing the data processing unit. So based on various applications, based on various nature of working, computer can be classified from three different scenarios. It can be classified according to the purpose, means for which purpose we are using the computer. Here we can classify it into two major groups. One class is known as general purpose computer and another is known as specific purpose computer. It is very clear by its name. By general purpose computer, I mean the computer which we use to perform a range of operations from scientific to business applications. So these computers are designed to perform a range of tasks. As it is performing different tasks, these computers are obviously versatile in nature. I hope you understand the meaning of versatility. A computer can perform different type of tasks with the same efficiency. Then computer, because they are meant to perform different type of jobs, that means they generally lacks in speed and efficiency. When we think computer according to specific purpose, that means their circuit is designed in such a manner that they are meant for to perform only a single task. If you want to perform another task, that means its circuitry is to be redesigned. That means they are non-versatile in nature. Then when they are designed to perform a specific type of task, that means they are master of its own task. Obviously, they provide the good speed and their results are more efficient in comparison to general purpose computer. More efficient these are. This is one classification according to the purpose which we are using. Then they may be divided in different categories according to data handling, means what type of data they are using. According to data handling, they can be classified in three major groups. This is analog, digital, and hybrid. The data which works on measuring technique are put under the category of analog computer. You must have observed these type of computers in your daily life. So example could be speedometer, or you may observe the devices, measuring devices at petrol pump. With the pressure of petrol, it measures its price as well as its quantity. Then another category could be digital computer. The difference between these two computers is it works on measuring units, it works on digits. It is for counting purposes, it is for measuring purpose, how much. So basically they can be categorized according to it works on how much and it is how many. Digital computers, people are using in our lab. These all computers are of digital type of computer, digital in nature, which works on either 0 and 1, or if they are using analog data, it must be converted into digital equivalent, then only this computer can perform these operations. And the devices, the unit where the combination of these two computers, type of computers are used is hybrid computer. Hybrid computer is the combination of analog as well as digital computer. Like in scientific applications, these type of computers are used where conversion from analog to digital and digital to analog must be there, then only the combination of this can be done. Example could be intensive care unit in hospital. It can be in manufacturing units, etc. Let's come to the most important classification of this computer, which we call the classification or the division of computer according to its functionality. What type of function it is performing, or you may also call it according to size, we can also categorize the computer. Here they can put into four different groups. One class is known as microcomputer, then mini computers, mainframe computers, and last one is supercomputer. By micro, obviously, I mean the smallest size of computer which is permitted to perform a single type of task. Mainly it was developed to perform single user applications only, but nowadays all these computers can be grouped together with the help of networking and they share the information from one computer to another. This is a small size computer. They can further be classified into two parts. One, in one class we put desktop computers, and in other class we put portable computers. Desktop computer is the computer which is at your home. Why it is known as desktop? Because it is placed on the top of disk. Then if I say this is non-portable computer, then I will not be wrong. By portable computer, I mean the type of computer which can be used while you are in move, because they don't need external power supply. They work on charged battery. So portable computers could be your laptops. They could be your notebook computer, which are smaller in size in comparison to laptop computers. Also, functionality is limited in comparison to laptop computers, but they are almost same, similar in nature. They can be handheld devices. In handheld devices, we can put PDAs, personal digital assistants. We can put digital diaries. Palmed computer can also be the example of this type of computer. Why these are known as handheld devices? Because they can be carrying in your hand, and the palm computer can be placed on the top of your palm. And if I will not mention the smartphone, then I'll not be completing my duties. Smartphone is also an example of handheld computers. I hope this classification is clear to you. But if I say the limitation of these type of computer, obviously it is they are limited in their functionalities and precision. If I move from micro to mini computers, obviously the capabilities of these computer is much more in comparison to micro, but it is less than mainframe computers. Then mini computers are designed to permit multi-user simultaneously. So these are also known as multi-user computers. They may allow from 4 users to 200 users simultaneously to work upon it. But the size of this computer is, you can say that, 2 drawer file cabinet. Mainframe computers can be termed as ultra high speed computer. Very much efficient in comparison to mini computers. They may allow from 100 to thousands of users to work simultaneously. Generally, these computers are used as server, or they may be used as a cluster of workstation to permit more than 100 or thousands users. And obviously, this is known as the highest speed computer. Supercomputers are known as highest speed computers. But the basic difference between mainframe and supercomputer is that it permits to allow multi-users to work simultaneously. But supercomputers never permits more than one program to be executed. Why we use it? They are generally needed for sensitive calculations. Generally, the speed of these computers are known as FLOP, floating point operations per second. And the operation less than 1 gigabyte instructions per second. Such type of computers cannot be put in the category of supercomputers. They allow millions and millions of instructions to be, floating point instructions rather, to be executed per unit of time. Moreover, if I talk about their examples, then Param, Cray, 3, these are few examples of supercomputers which are known as, which are used for weather forecasting, for scientific applications, for launching space vehicles in space. But I have categorized, I have grouped so many computers in different categories, but these computers, these lines are not separated. You cannot say that if the computer is digital, it will not be desktop computer. If the computer is a hybrid in nature, it will not be a general purpose computer, no. These computer, microcomputer, which we are discussing, which we will be using, of course, comes under digital computers. So this classification we have given for the purpose of better understanding. It never means that this classification is distinct in nature and no part is overlapping each other.